boys and girls, welcome to Kevin's Corner. I'm Kevin, and this is my corner. Hee hee. Well, let's play a guessing game. I'm going to give you some clues. And when you know what I'm talking about, shout it out really loud. Spring. Baskets. Jelly beans. Sunday. Hide. Chocolate. Rabbit. Eggs. What? What did you say? Easter? That's right. Those clues are all about Easter because Easter is just a few weeks away. We have a special treat on today's show. We visited a real live bunny. This bunny's name is Mr. Chloe Rabbit. He is 12 years old. He lives in a condominium with his owner. Check it out.
You ready to come out? Hi, my name is Helen Eddington, and this is my pet rabbit, Chloe. This is his cage that he stays in. It's very large, with enough room for him to move around and be comfortable. Every morning, Chloe has supervised time outside of the cage within a bunny-proofed area that is protected from and appropriate for digging and chewing. Chloe loves to chew and dig because it keeps his teeth and nails worn down. And he wants to make a bunny burrow. He loves to eat, and he sleeps more and more the older he gets. He loves his midday naps. He also loves to explore and sniff, to hop and jump around, and he'll cuddle and give kisses by licking with his tongue. The food is hay-based products, which is very healthy for rabbits to help wear down their teeth, because they're constantly growing. He also gets romaine lettuce every morning, which he loves, but his favorite treat is a little piece of banana. He goes bananas for bananas.
Ready?
He loves going after that ball. I put in some sunflower seeds, and sometimes I'll add a half of a peanut or two, maybe a small piece of walnut or almond, but it's mostly some sunflower seeds.
You smell that banana? You do. You want some? You do.
Aw. What a good bunny.
You want some more? You do.
If you listen closely, you can hear him chomping on it and snorting sometimes.
What's that?
Chloe says it's time for his lettuce and his midday nap. And he says, thank you for coming. I think on average they're supposed to get about a cup of greens every day. But the lettuce is the easiest thing for us to have for him every day. Sometimes we'll offer something else too, but it's romaine lettuce has a lot of nutrients in it. You definitely don't want to give them iceberg lettuce because that does nothing for them. It's just mostly water. There's no nutrients in there. Okay, it's in your cage. Rest is in your cage, mister. Yeah, you're welcome. Go on. Yeah, it's a good bunny. Even though rabbits are very cute, they're not just a present to give. They are a complicated commitment.
Mr. Chloe Rabbit is a big, cute bunny, and he and Helen have lots of fun together. But, like Helen said, having an indoor rabbit for a pet is a big commitment. Also, rabbits don't especially like to be held. So, if you aren't prepared to feed, clean up after, and groom a live rabbit, maybe you should stick with a stuffed bunny. Or a chocolate bunny where you can bite off the ears. I like chocolate bunnies. Well, boys and girls, on this show, instead of reciting a poem, we're going to dramatize the tale of Peter Rabbit, which was written by Beatrix Potter over 100 years ago. Dramatize means we're going to act it out. Candy is going to play the role of the mother rabbit. And Steve from Kids News is going to play the role of Mr. McGregor. Peter Rabbit is being played by himself. I'm the narrator of the story. Places, everyone. Shall we begin? Once upon a time, there were four little rabbits. And their names were Flopsy, Mopsy, Cottontail, and Peter. They lived with their mother rabbit in a sandbank underneath the root of a very big fir tree.
Now, my sweet little bunnies, I must go to the baker and get some bread. While I'm gone, I want you to stay inside and play. You can even watch Calvin's Corner on television if you would like. You're not to go outside, and you are never ever to go into Mr. McGregor's garden. Do you understand? Peter, are you listening?
Yes, Mother.
What did I say?
You are going to buy some bread.
And?
We can watch television while you are gone.
And where are you never ever to go?
Into Mr. McGregor's garden.
And so Mother Rabbit left her four bunnies and went to the baker's. But Peter was a curious bunny, and sometimes very naughty. As soon as Mother Rabbit left, Peter hopped out of the rabbit hole and jumped through the fence and into Mr. McGregor's garden. He began to taste the vegetables.
I wonder what this is. Yuck! Ew! That stinks and tastes really bad. This is pretty. It's round and red. Maybe it's a tomato. I love tomatoes. That is definitely not a tomato. It is hard and crunchy. I wonder what this is. It doesn't smell bad. Yummy! I like this. I wonder what else good old Mr. McGregor has in his garden. Oh wow, I know what this is. This is a carrot. I love carrots.
Well, boys and girls, Peter was so busy eating and enjoying Mr. McGregor's carrots that he didn't see Mr. McGregor coming to the garden. What's this? I think someone's been tasting my onions. And I think someone's taking a bite out of my radishes. Peter, getting very full of carrots, stopped munching and heard Mr. McGregor coming toward him. He jumped up and hopped behind a clay pot that was laying in the garden.
Oh no, here comes Mr. McGregor!
Someone's been eating my beets. Where is that rascal? That varmint's been eating my carrots. Fee, fi, fo, funny. I think I smell a bad little bunny. I'll get you, my pretty, and your little cottontail, too.
Were you good little bunnies while I was gone? Peter, are you okay? You are shivering. Are you sick?
I think I might be coming down with something. I think I should go to bed early.
Okay, Peter. By the way, I saw the strangest thing as I passed the fence in front of Mr. McGregor's garden. He has put up a picture of a bunny on the fence, and the weirdest thing is, the bunny looks just like you.
The end. Do you think Peter Rabbit learned his lesson and will stay at Mr. McGregor's garden from now on? He was sure scared, so I bet he never goes there again. Well, boys and girls, that's it for this time. I hope you enjoyed meeting Mr. Chloe Rabbit and hearing the tale of Peter Rabbit. I hope you have a very happy Easter. Oh, and don't forget to hide your eggs. Until next time, Calvin's Corner, Calvin's Corner, woo!